Hi guys, I'm back with the RC electronics repair tutorial, which is intended for guys that are just scratching the surface in electronics, and I'm trying to get to every component we could find in FPV electronics. We talked about resistors and capacitors, and now it's time for another building block in electronic design, and that's the diode. I arranged here some of them. I guess you are wondering what an LED is sitting next to diodes, and the answer is pretty simple. LED means light emitting diode. And if you tried to power an LED and by mistake you powered it with reverse polarity, you found out that the LED is not lighting up. And that's because of the basic characteristic of the diode. Diodes, you can think of them as a one-way valve. They are passing current only into one direction and block it in the other direction. And starting from this main characteristic, we can use diodes for a lot of things. Essentially, we can use them for reverse polarity protection and save you if you were dumb and powered an electronic device by reversing the polarity. And another thing that the diode is useful is for separating current sources. Like for example, on a flight controller, we have two or in very rare cases more current sources. For example, we have the 5 volt coming from the LiPo, or 5 volt regulator coming from the LiPo, and we have the 5 volt coming from the USB. And because you don't want to backfeed the LiPo 5 volt to the USB 5 volt line, you just separate the two sources by passing the current through a diode. Another thing that the diodes are used pretty often is transforming AC into DC by forcing current to flow into one direction, because AC is alternating. I have here different building types of diodes. This is a true hole, and this is mainly used on older equipment or high power equipment. And these are the surface mount you will see on FPV electronics. This is a 3-pin diode. And you can find one diode inside or two diodes connecting each other on one pole and going to the other two poles separated. You have the normal diode with two poles. Also, I don't know if you can see it or not, there is a white stripe on one side of the diode, and that represents the flow of the current coming from the section without the white stripe and going out where the white stripe is. If you want to put current to flow from here to here, you cannot. Also, on this through hole one, we can see a black circle on one side of the diode, and that represents the same thing. Next, going to check some flight controllers and see if we can spot some diodes on the PCBs. Again, as I told you in previous videos, I will not get into working theories or details regarding the theory of operation of diodes. I will try to explain it as simple as possible. We can look here at the KISS V2 flight controller, and we can see here a diode which is used to protect the flight controller from reverse polarity situation. We can also see here a diode which is used to clamp or to limit the voltage if spikes are present in the system. And we can also see here a diode which is separating the 5 volt coming from the USB. On the other side, we can see here a diode which is separating the 5 volt coming from the 5 volt regulator that's connected to the LiPo. Going to another flight controller, here is a DIODES flight controller. We can already see a diode here. And is there another one? Yes, there is another one here. Okay, on the other side, we can see one here, one here, and a little tiny one here. Don't underestimate diodes. They are a very important building block in electronic designs, and there are a lot of types of diodes on the market, but essentially they have variations in the working characteristics. Like for example the zener, which I told you on the fly controller. The zener usually clamps the voltage at one point, and you can take diodes that clamp at, I don't know, 30 volts, 3.3 volts, 100 volts and so on. And of course, there are a lot of other types of diodes. I just summed the little ones and the usual ones that we can see on fly controllers, ESCs and so on. Guys, thank you very much for watching. I encourage you to leave a comment if you have questions, or even contact me on social media for different infos if you need them or not. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next time.